My dad was quite sick, so my mum thought if we had the shop, this would give us a living and accommodation. The Elite Cafe was a very small little cafe, but it had the old rock and roll booths. Then eventually we moved to the next shop of Titherly's, which had become vacant.
Titherly's Universal Store was on the corner.
Everything they'd sold, grain, bulk kerosene, clothing, and it was just a massive big general store. Big open crates where they had sold oats and grain.
I reckon they'd probably say four or five people working there. You had somebody in the drapery department, somebody in the hardware part of it, you know, somebody in the grocery part of it and that there, you know. It was a big shop.
Floor to ceiling shelving, and some of the local boys used to come in. There was a mirror there, and if they were getting ready to go out for Saturday night, they had their Brill cream still sitting on the shelf, you know, so that was their shelf, that was their Brill cream.
Very old fashioned, but there was always a chair for you to sit on. I do remember that hard wooden chair, a big long counter, and it always had this smell of material and that sort of thing. They sold everything. You know, they said from a pin to an engine.
And they put a thing in, it was stuck with vacuum, you whooshed up onto this mezzanine floor.
The lady used to sit right up there, and he'd put the money in the bill, and he'd swish it up, and she'd look at it and give you your change and down in the cup.
And every Friday night on the 7:30 train, all these boxes of cakes and lamingtons and cream buns would arrive. Bread was just wrapped in one layer of tissue paper. We wrote the name on the tissue paper, but the ends weren't sealed. We all survived. Nobody was poisoned.